city stuck in time, boasting of a rich heritage, culture and history. Views that will literally take your breath away, and of course, there are the adventure sports. In today's episode, we unfold the treasures of Tanahun. We leave from Kathmandu, traveling west through the Prithivinarayan Highway to reach Bimalnagar. After some rock climbing and caving adventure, we move further to reach the very beautiful Bandipur for a perfect ending to the trip.
The thing about Nepal is, everywhere you find beauty. It could be natural, cultural or historical beauty, or an amalgamation of all three, just like in our trip this time.
We started with some rock climbing adventure on the limestone rock surface of Bimalnagar, which is named Iman Ko Samjanama.
It's called Iman Ko Samjanama because Iman Guru was a very famous, very, very loved mountain in his country. And then his friends, his colleagues, basically a lot of his students as well, they got together and then they made like it to open this as a climbing place.
And off we went. This 50 meters of rock face had a total of 4 pitches. Our plan was to only reach up to the 3rd pitch and abseil back.
And you're here after the earthquake. And he's gonna be here for a long time because he said he loves it. Either way.
Rock climbing is definitely not as easy as it seems. You obviously need to be in great physical form, and more than that, you need to concentrate a lot. And of course, it tests your patience.
Having so much fun actually. Just hanging out, doing nothing. Waiting for somebody to fix the rope and so that I can go up. As he said, I'm doing pretty alright. It's alright, but it's tiring. Oh my god, it's tiring.
And while I was away for almost 3 hours doing the climb, my team found this young power girl who was happily displaying her scooter stunts at the local field. It was only later that we found out that this pretty lady was also a popular beauty queen of the region.
सानैदेखि बाइक चलाएर हिँड्थे हैन बाबाले चाहिँ अब जियोस यस्तै एडभेन्चरमा चाहिँ जानु पर्छ अब छोरी भनेर छोरी जस्तै गएर बस्ने हैन कि छोरा जस्तै भएर हिँड्नु पर्छ भनेर पहिला स्कुटर भन्दा नि मैले पहिला बाइक चलाउन थालेको थिएँ त्यसरी नै अब राइडिङ ग्रुपहरूमा जोइन भयो राइडर्स युनिफाइड त्यतैबाट नै अनि म स्टन्टहरू सिक्न थालेको एक वर्ष जति भयो पहिला चाहिँ म मिस नेपालमा जान्छु भन्ने सोच्थेँ र यतिकै अब मिस नेपाल मिस कहाँ हुँदैछ भनेपछि अब देख्छु अब कस्तो हुन्छ भनेर भाग लिएँ के अरे अनि त्यतिकैमा मिस सानो ट्यालेन्टमा मैले स्टन्ट देखाएको थिएँ र स्टन्ट ट्यालेन्ट राउन्डमा म विन मतलब अवार्ड पनि पाएँ मिस ट्यालेन्टको अवार्ड पनि पाएँ मैले
A popular half-day trip in the area is caving in Siddha Gufa. At 437 meters deep and 50 meters high, we headed towards the largest cave in the entire country and the second largest cave in the whole of Asia.
And she is the Miss Tanahu, and Miss Tanahu is showing us around. How lucky are we, right?
Caves before like the Mahindra Gufa or Chamera Gufa in Pokhara, but nothing beats Siddha Gufa. To start off with, it was gigantic and the rappelling was definitely scary but also a lot of fun. And I'd never seen so many bats at once ever in my life.
Behind me, there are like I think a million bats. Scary but fascinating at the same time.
We kept walking and walking, but the cave never ended.
So about a decade ago, Hindu Baba came here and ate only fruits and lived here for a good 1 month before moving on to a different meditation spot. His wooden slipper, as you can see, is still here. Fascinating.
The limestones inside the cave over many years seems to have taken interesting shapes too. Some of the striking ones, as our guide pointed out, were Leknath Paudel, the famous Nepali poet, Buddha in meditation, the beak of a parrot, and the royal crown or sheepage of our kings of the yesteryear. Just like clouds, one can interpret the way one wants of the many limestone formations, said our guide. Well, true that.
And with this, we come to an end of our caving adventure here in Siddha Gufa.
Winding roads alongside lush greenery will take you to this picturesque paradise that is perched on a hilltop at 1030 meters.
Although it was a little cloudy when we reached Bandipur, the place couldn't be any less charming. I mean, I was not hoping to be awestruck by Bandipur the way I was.
History has it that Bandipur was formerly a Magar village. Ban, which means forest, and Di, which means water in Magar language, basically translates to a place surrounding with forest and lots of water, and hence the place was named Bandipur. Then around 250 years ago, Newar businessmen from Patan, Kathmandu and Bhaktapur came over to trade and put up an open market in Bandipur's Turikhel, which was once a bustling venue for Indo-Tibetan business deals. After the Prithibi Narayan Highway was built in the 1950s, the businessmen went away and what remained was its ancient city stuck in time, boasting of preserved ancient buildings and fields of almost European ambience. Thank you.
Now I know why Bandipur is such a famous destination for lyricists, writers, or poets. The place is a secret hideout, and it is so peaceful and so beautiful.
We also visited a century-old library located right in the center of the Bandipur city. The library was first established by the then Prime Minister Chandrasamshir, but was quickly closed down as the reign of the time was against any kind of education. Then the library was re-established in 2001 Bikram Samvat in the condition that it would be named after the then PM Padma Shamshir. The library was hence named Padma Library. After a quick tour of the city, off we went to our next destination.
And that's it for Bandipur and Bimalnagar episode. I hope you enjoyed as much as I enjoyed exploring it for Sami Adventures. Thank you for watching and see you all next week.
नेपाली हाम्रो नेपाल हाम्रो देश बनाउने दायित्व मबाट सुरु हुन्छ।